の時代、いつの時でも悪が栄えた試しはない。
Golden Bat is generally considered the world's first superhero, originally appearing as part of paper theater presentations across Japan in 1931. The character's popularity eventually led to Golden Bat being featured in live-action movies, anime, manga, and a wide range of merchandise and toys. As one of Japan's first pop culture phenomena and media exports, the character would also go on to have tremendous influence across the world. To learn more about Golden Bat's full history, I recommend watching Kenny Latterdale's excellent video on the character. Use the link in the description below to check it out. In this episode, we're going to focus on one of Golden Bat's most well-known appearances, the 1966 tokusatsu movie simply titled Golden Bat. Produced by Toei and released on December 21st of 1966, this film features a relatively straightforward storyline that blends elements from the science fiction, fantasy, and superhero genres. It would serve as a pilot vehicle for the anime series that would go on to premiere on April of 1967. The story opens with aspiring astronomer Akira Kasahaya warning the authorities that planet Icarus has been set off course and is going to collide with Earth. Dismissed by the scientists at the observatory, who fail to take him seriously, Akira ends up being recruited by Dr. Yamatone to the UN's Pearl Research Institute. This secretive organization's mission is to detect threats that could pose a danger to Earth and help to counter them. They have a secret weapon that will help protect Earth from a collision with Icarus, the Super Destruction Beam Cannon. However, they are missing suitable materials to build the last component needed to complete the weapon, a lens that can withstand its intense heat. Fortunately, an SOS call from the special unit looking for these materials leads Dr. Yamatone to the lost island of Atlantis, where they also learn who is responsible for setting planet Icarus on a collision course with Earth, the evil ruler Naso. Cornered by Naso's forces and out of options, the Research Institute's team awakens the dormant figure they find hidden deep in the underground sarcophagus, Golden Bat. The skull-faced hero quickly springs into action to protect the research team and challenge Naso and his forces as a self-proclaimed protector of justice. From this point through the end of the movie, Golden Bat would become an ally to Dr. Yamatone's team and help them in their mission to protect the planet. Despite the simple story and execution, this film would go on to have tremendous influence in Toei's future tokusatsu hero works. This was in part thanks to some of its production staff, which included many individuals who go on to define Toei's golden era of tokusatsu heroes. These include Susumu Takaku, who was in charge of Golden Bat's screenplay. Susumu, who prior to this film was the primary writer for Ambassador Magma, Space G-Man, and Ninja Unit Moonlight, would also go on to become the main writer for Captain Ultra, Inazuman Flash, and Battle Fever J. He also contributed to several other well-known tokusatsu works, including the Super Sentai series and the Metal Hero series. As such, Golden Bat makes use of many narrative and presentation elements that have that unique Toei tokusatsu hero flair to them, from Golden Bat's proclamation of his mission to fight evil to his dramatic last-minute appearances to save the day. It's all here. and while the overall execution is rough compared to later tokusatsu hero works, it's still incredibly entertaining to watch. The movie is also well known for featuring Sonny Chiba in one of his earliest starring roles as Dr. Yamatone. The actor, who previously appeared in other early tokusatsu works, including Invasion of the Neptune Man, Seven Color Mask, and Messenger of Allah, would go on to have an incredible film career and become a world-renowned performer. Additionally, he will go on to establish the Japan Action Club, an organization dedicated to helping actors train in martial arts and stunt work for television and film. The Japan Action Club would go on to become an integral resource for all tokusatsu hero productions. Golden Bat also features another well-known tokusatsu genre actor in one of his earliest roles, Hirohisa Nakata. The actor would go on to appear as the title character in Captain Ultra in April of 1967, just 3 months after appearing in Golden Bat. This would be followed by appearances in many other works, including Kamen Rider Amazon, where he appeared as Cyril the Great, Kaiketsu Subot, Shōdenshi Bioman, where he was featured as Mason, Godzilla vs. Byrodante, and Kamen Rider 01. The music soundtrack for the film was composed by another talented individual who would go on to become a major part of Toei's Tokusatsu Hero and Super Robot programs, Chunsuke Kikuchi. While Golden Bat's soundtrack is relatively early in his career, it's definitely recognizable as one of his works. As a foundational work of the tokusatsu hero genre, I highly recommend fans to make time to watch this movie. Golden Bat provides a great view into the origins of the tokusatsu hero genre, plus, it's a fantastic movie that stands on its own.